Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making a chocolate chip iron skillet cookie. And it's just what it sounds like. It's going to be a chocolate chip cookie, kind of a giant size cookie, because it's going to be baked in an iron skillet. We're starting with butter. I have 6 tablespoons of butter that I've softened to room temperature. To that, I'm adding brown sugar, 3/4 cup firmly packed brown sugar. Now stir in 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract and 1 egg. This egg has a double yolk. That's fine, it's still just 1 egg. Next, we stir in 1 cup of all-purpose flour along with 1 1/2 teaspoons of baking powder and 1/2 teaspoon of salt. After stirring in those dry ingredients, what you will have is a dough. It's a cookie dough. And we're going to make it chocolate chip cookies by adding 1 1/2 cups of semi-sweet chocolate chips. Just stir those in. Now spread this in the bottom of a cast iron skillet. I'm going to say that that's what I'm using, but you do not have to use a cast iron skillet. You may use any type of skillet that's this width and depth. It's 10 inches across this way, and you can see that it has about a couple of inches of depth, but you probably won't need that. But you could even use a square pan if you want yours to come out square. But this will be baked in the next step. But first, I need to spread it out as evenly as I can. And you'll notice that I have treated the bottom. I did rub butter all over the bottom and up the sides a little. And then I put flour, just a sprinkling over it, and let that run around the bottom. This goes to a 350-degree oven, and it will bake for about 20 minutes. I'm going to use a toothpick test, which means a toothpick goes in the center. If it comes out clean, then it's done. And I will take the cookie up just as soon as it's done. Our chocolate chip iron skillet cookie is done and out of the oven. Actually, it's just been out for about 2 minutes, so it's really hot. But you know I like to taste things when they're warm. And I'm going to give this a try because I did take a knife and make a cut here and a cut here. And you can see that it pretty much will stay together. If it were chilled or if it just were room temperature, there would be no problem at all. I have gone around the edge. It loosens very easily. So let's bring our plate over closer and try to prepare a place on the plate where there's enough room. And we'll see if we can get this piece. And some of the edges will probably fall down, but that won't affect the taste. This is what your chocolate chip cookie will look like. It looks like pie, almost. But anyway, we're serving it with vanilla ice cream, which is a great combination. If you would prefer, you could use sweetened whipped cream. It would be nice to have a little garnish. I didn't think to go out and get some mint, but that would be good with this. It would make a pretty picture. So I'm going to take a taste of our big cookie, and I'll get a little from the end here and a little ice cream to go with it. And the majority of the taste comes from the cookie, so that's basically what I'm tasting. I can't describe to you how good that is straight from the oven. It is so warm and wonderful against the cold ice cream. And the flavor of the ice cream is not so strong that it overpowers the chocolate chip cookie. The cookie itself is delicious. I think you'll love it. It will look like pieces of pie, but that's the way it's meant to be. I do want to say that I used a cast iron skillet because I thought that looked kind of different and you would be interested in it, but some of you aren't going to have that. So you'll be substituting other skillets, and any skillet that is oven proof that will hold it in a reasonable way is fine. Check the handle. If the handle is plastic or could melt in the oven, don't use that. So it has to be fully oven safe for you to do this cookie in it. It's not worth risking your cookware. What you should do is just put it in a brownie pan or something like that, and you'll get a thicker cookie, but it'll be good.